Today's Bible reading is taken from Matthew chapter 7, verses 1 to 11. 今晚的经文取自于马太福音七章一至十一节. Do not judge, or you too will be judged. For in the same way you judge others, you will be judged. And with the measure you use, it will be measured to you. Why do you look at the speck of sawdust in your brother's eye and pay no attention to the plank in your own eye? How can you say to your brother, let me take the speck out of your eye, when all the time there is a plank in your own eye? You hypocrite. First take the plank out of your own eye, then you will see clearly to remove the speck from your brother's eye. Do not give dogs what is sacred. Do not throw pigs. Do not throw your pearls to pigs. If you do, they may trample them under their feet and then turn and tear you to pieces. Ask, and it will be given to you. Seek, and you will find. Knock, and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks, receives. He who seeks, finds. And to him who knocks, the door will be opened. Which of you, if his son asks for bread, will give him a stone? Or if he asks for a fish, will give him a snake? If you then, though you are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Father in heaven give good gifts to those who ask him? This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Amen.
Someone said, avoid casting stones at others, lest stones be cast back at you.
有人说呢，我们要禁止呢拿石头呢去丢别人呢，免得呢那石头呢会打回我们呢。 那这句话的意思呢，就是说呢，我们要不要那么快的就给予呢，就指出别人的缺点，免得呢别人可能呢会对我们呢就评头论足了。那另一方，那换句话说呢，就是呢，我们要待人良善。
在跟人相处的时候呢，我们要有同理心，彼此的了解以及存有谦卑的心。因为呢，我们如何待别人呢，别人也会怎样的待我们。那我们已经到了这个登山宝训的这个信息系列的尾声了。那我们从中呢，也学习到如何在神的国里面呢，能够学习成为神的百姓。
那这礼拜呢，我们学习的主题呢，就是关系的衡量。神的话语呢，就挑战我们呢，再一次的思考，那我们跟人与人之间的关系，特别呢，是我们在主里面的弟兄姐妹。 那也同时呢，也挑战我们呢，我们如何去审视我们如何去看待我们的父，而不是呢就只是当他是一个有的没的这样。我们可以发现到呢，谦卑呢是维持我们彼此的关系，人与人之间的关系，以及我们跟神的关系。 那我们就来看一看呢这个经文呢，那么这个经文呢是很容易被误解啊，甚至很多时候呢，不只是我们信徒，我们相信主的，甚至那些还没有相信主的呢，都很容易呢在这一个的经文里面所误解的，那就是呢不要论断别人，免得你们被论断。 那有一本圣经注释呢，他就把这个第一节呢总结呢，就这样说到呢，在你还没有准备好，同时用同样的标准来论断别人之前呢，我们就不要论断别人了哈。那如果是说呢，当我们论断别人的时候呢，我们要保持这谦卑的这个态度。 当我们要操练这一个论断的时候呢，我们不可以走到两边的极端里面去。
Don't be quick to judge and also don't avoid exercising.
我们不要就轻易的就另外一个极端呢，就是很快的就下这个的论断，也不要就是回避，就完全不说的这样子的一个论断。
You may have heard or know of examples like the following.
你可能有听过以下的这些例子。 那第一个呢，就是呢，能够批评就别人的这个行为，那就是直接的就判断这个很判断性的这样的一个论断。哎，你有没有听过呢？谁某某人呢？他最近好像没来教会呢？ 你没有听过这 A 某某跟 B 某某他们之间发生什么事情啊？然后从中呢又加盐添醋了。为什么这个人会来教会呢？你看他这种生活方式，这种衣着的穿着呢，可能上天堂吗？这种人？ 或者就是说一个完全拒绝能够去对错误的保持沉默的这样的一个的状态。我不需要你对我的这你我不需要你对我这样举头乱足这样子的啊，就你记得不要乱说话。有些时候呢，这一些的回应啊，这一些的评论啊，对我是有帮助我们成长的。 它就是很像是一个支持，以及帮我们能够进步的，而不就是那一种的一些八卦的这种类似的论断。而另外一个的极端呢，就是呢完全的保持沉默，就是完全不提了。我觉得他们应该有做错，但是我就点到为止，就这样而已。 那其实呢是很重要，对这种不公正啊，还有错误的行为呢，能够有这样的一种发生，这种的有建设性的论断是很重要的。那么我们指出一些人的一些不良的行为以及不公平的这种判断呢，是这种的品格呢，并就不是一件一个很坏的事情。 因此呢，在马太福音第七章一节呢，这里呢，他不是叫我们回避论断。他也不是呢，就是命令我们停止用智慧啊、常识啊这种道德的勇气呢，就结合上帝的话语，然后来去辨别是非、判断真理的。耶稣从来没有说过不可以论断人呢。 让我们来看看这个经文的深入的诚意到底是在说什么。在马太福音七章二到三节这里，耶稣就说到：“因为你们怎样论断人，也必怎样被论断；你们用什么量器量给人，也什么量器量给你们。看见你弟兄眼中有刺，却不想自己眼中有良木呢？” 所以我们自己看到的这个的木屑还有梁木的这个比喻呢，是非常的生动的。木屑呢，基本上是微不足道，是很微小的。 那梁木呢，就是整个拦阻我们的，就是我这个我们无法忍受这个东西，是个很大的事情。如果有大雨风暴呢，把一棵树呢，一棵树呢倒下来，就成了一个梁木了。倒下之后呢，我们需要很大很费力的把这个东西移除掉的。所以耶稣在这里的比喻呢，就说明到我们人啊，人们啊，常常就只盯着别人那个小缺点，那么对自己的大毛病呢，就完全视而不见。那么因此呢，当我们仔细看这个上下文，还有这个经文的背景的时候呢，那么耶稣他并不是反对这些的论断，而是反对虚伪自以为意的这种方式来论断。
Habit of distorting spiritual truth for hypocritical self-righteousness as the Pharisees and the religious of the law did.
耶稣呢，他是反对像法利赛人那样子，就是带着一个虚伪的自义呢，然后扭曲属灵的真理。
And this is pride, which is the opposite of humility.
这就是骄傲，那也就是谦卑的反面。
And Jesus revealed this kind of distortion and pride in John chapter 7.
那么耶稣呢，就在约翰福音第七章里面呢，就揭露了这种扭曲真理的自傲的行为了。
When the people were mad at Jesus, angry at Jesus for healing a man's whole body on the Sabbath, Jesus answered this.
当在耶稣在安息日医治人的时候呢，那这些人就开始就很生气的，很不爽了。那耶稣就这样子啊。
Now, if a boy can be circumcised on the Sabbath, so that the law of Moses may not be broken, why are you angry with me for healing a man's whole body on the Sabbath? Stop judging by mere appearances, but instead judge correctly.
人若在安息了受割礼呢，免得违背摩西的律法。我在安息了叫一个人全然好了，你们就向我生气吗？不可按外貌断定是非，总要按公平断定是非。
And later on, while teaching in the temple courts,
那么之后呢，耶稣也在圣殿教导的时候就说到
，The teachers of the law and the Pharisees brought in a woman caught in adultery, and then they tried to use this question to trap Jesus.
那这些的宗教的老师，这些宗教师呢，这些法律，这些法利赛人以及律法师呢，就带着一个被犯奸淫的这妇人呢，就把他抓到耶稣的面前，就是要拷问耶稣，要陷害耶稣。
They asked, "Teacher, teacher, this woman was caught in the act of adultery. In the law of Moses, commanded us to stone such woman. Now, what do you say?"
他们就对耶稣说呢，夫子啊，这妇人是正行淫之时被拿的。摩西在律法书上吩咐我们把这样的妇人用石头打死。你说该把她怎么样呢？
What did Jesus do?
耶稣的回应是怎样呢？
First, his response was directed to the people judging the woman.
耶稣他首先呢，还是向那些立刻要就是要审判的这个妇人的这些人呢，来做出回应。
The English one, let's read together. One, two, go. When they kept on questioning him, he straightened up and said to them, "Let any one of you who is without sin be the first to throw a stone at her." Again, he stooped down and wrote on the ground. At this, those who heard began to go away one at a time, the older ones first, until only Jesus was left with the woman still standing there.
他们在那当时候呢，他们的回应就是呢，他们还是不住的问耶稣，就问他，耶稣就直起腰来对他们说，你们中间谁是没有罪的，谁就可以先拿石头打他。于是又弯着腰用指头在地上写字。他们听见这话，就从老到少一个一个的都出去了，只剩下耶稣一人，还有那人站在当中。
What Jesus did here is challenging those who judged to first examine themselves and their motives.
耶稣在这里呢，是首先是对那一些要审判这个女人的那一个群众来说，我们要教他们呢去审查自己的那个动机。
Because ultimately, the purpose to judge someone else's weakness fairly must be to help the person to walk in freedom, not bringing them out of one prison to another.
因为最终呢，这个公平的这个论断呢，是论断他人软弱的目的呢，是帮助这个人呢走向自由，而不是呢让他从一个的牢笼呢走到另外一个牢笼里去。
Okay, I repeat this one because the slide I mixed up the order. There's a slight one. The purpose to judge someone else's weakness fairly must be to help the person to walk in freedom, not bringing them out of one prison to another.
那这里就说到呢，一个真正论断他人的弱点的目的，应该是帮助这个人呢走向自由的，而不是将他从一个的牢笼呢带到另外一个牢笼里去的。
And so, in verse 10 and 11, Jesus turned to this woman and he said this, "Woman, where are they? Has no one condemned you?" "No one, sir," she said. "Then neither do I condemn you." Jesus declared, "Go now and live your life of sin."
接下来呢，耶稣呢就转身呢，就对着这个犯了奸淫的这个的妇人呢，就对他说呢。 就妇人，那些人在哪里呢？没有人定你的罪吗？他说：“主啊，没有。”耶稣说：“我也不定你的罪，去吧，从此不要再犯罪了。”
So it's really about examining ourselves before we say anything to others.
因此呢，最终呢，就是要我们审查自己内心，而不是我们就是直截了当的评断别人。
And when we do say something to others, it is with a purpose. To help the person.
当我们说一些事情呢，或者是我们论断某一些人的时候呢，我们的主要的目的是帮助别人。
That's why in Matthew 7, 4 to 5, here it says, "How can you say to your brother, 'Let me take the speck out of your eye,' when all the time there's a plank in your own eye? You hypocrite, first take the plank out of your own eye, and then you will see clearly to remove the speck from your brother's eye."
因此呢，在马太福音7章4到5节呢，就说到：“你眼中有梁木，怎么能对你弟兄说，容我去掉你眼中的刺呢？你是假冒伪善的人，先去掉自己眼中的梁木，然后才能看得清楚，去掉你弟兄眼中的刺。”
Notice this. Jesus expects us to deal with the speck, but do it with humility.
耶稣期待我们呢，就是去处理呢别人的这些的这些的刺就小错了，但是呢要保持着这种谦卑的态度。
Verse 5 basically means examine yourself first so that you can see clearly to discern and judge clearly to help others see clearly.
那么第五节这里就主要是说到呢，要我们审查自己，以至于我们能够看清楚如何去帮助、去论断、去鼓励一些我们需要帮助的这些弟兄姐妹。
So as the commentator summarized well, saying, "Do not judge others until you are prepared to be judged by the same standard, and then when you exercise judgment towards others, do it with humility."
因此呢，注释书他就做了这个很妙的总结，就说到在论断别人之前呢，先意识自己能否承受这样的程度的这样的论断。那么接着呢，就当我们真的要去论断别人的时候呢，记得要保持谦卑的这样的态度。Be
brothers and sisters, not judges. God is the ultimate judge.
我们是要成为主内的弟兄姐妹，而不是论断者，因为主呢，我们的神，他才是最终的审判者。
Recently, a few people reshared this, and I think it's fitting to what we are learning tonight.
最近呢，就有一些人呢就分享了这样的一个信息呢。那我觉得这个分享的这个内容呢，是蛮适合我们今晚学习的。
The post says the church is not always judgmental. Sometimes you just don't like the correction.
这个内容是说到了教会呢，并不总是呢就是爱论断人的，只是有时候呢，你不喜欢别人指出你的问题。
God often tries to teach and challenge us to grow through various situations, including correction from others.
那么上帝呢，很多时候呢，就借着不同的教导啦，甚至不同的方式呢，来使我们受教，然后使到我们能够成长。那么包括呢，从一些别人的错误成长当中学习。
And by the way, in your baptism card, it is written you are, as a church member, you are open to the correction of the priest and pastor one.
那记得弟兄姐妹, 我们的心里,
you go back and check.
我们心里卡了,里面有写到呢, 我们是, 带着一个, 一个谦卑的心, 被纠正的, 这样的态度呢, 来在教会当中呢, 彼此的生活的, 回去检查一下。
But we may sometimes react defensively, leading to a missed opportunity for personal growth and alignment to God's will.
那么有些时候呢, 我们就是可能会因为这种我们太过于那种太过防备的这种心态呢, 就是或者是, 太过的反应激烈过度, 从因为这样子呢, 能够错失我们个人的成长, 以至于我们就, 没办法遵循他旨意的这个良机了。
Therefore, before we even think about judging others, or when we are being judged by others, let us examine ourselves and rethink how we react and how we respond.
因此呢, 当我们呢, 要去, 论断别人, 或者, 有人论断我们的时候呢, 那我们首先呢, 我们要审查自己呢, 那么, 另外也是需要, 当别人论断我们的时候呢, 我们要想一想, 我们要怎么去回应。
And as the church, the people of God, we are all called to be salt and light in the world. We have learned this before.
那我们教会呢, 就是神, 神的百姓呢, 我们是被召呢, 是成为盐和光, 成为世界的盐和光。
We know that the kingdom of God with its truth is a treasure.
我们知道呢, 神的这个, 神的国呢, 是带着真理, 是无比珍贵的宝藏。
Like a precious pearl that we would give up everything just to have it.
就像一个珍贵的珠宝呢, 我们要抛弃一切, 为了就是得到它。
And we are called to share this good news of the kingdom of God to everyone.
我们被召呢, 就是为了分享这个天国的福音呢, 给每一个人。
However, there will be times, and maybe you have experienced it, there will be times we will meet and encounter proud and self-righteous Pharisees.
那么, 当然有些时候啦, 不幸的, 有些时候呢, 我们也会遇到这种呢, 我们自以为意的, 很像法利赛人那样子的。
At times, we may not even know and realize they are like that until we have tried to kind of like reach out to them.
有时候呢, 直到我们要试图去接触他们的时候呢, 我们才意识到, 诶, 我们才是这样的人呢。
他们是这样的人。
啊,对对对,
While we still love them, okay, we still be brother and a sister to them.
当然我们仍然爱他们哦,
Jesus also tells us, don't waste such a valuable thing to those who won't appreciate it and might even get offended by it.
耶稣呢, 也告诉我们哦, 不要把如此宝贵的真理呢, 浪费在那些不欣赏他, 甚至会因此感到冒犯的人的身上。
Despite hearing Jesus claim to be the Messiah, the response of the Pharisees and the religious leaders was rejection and hatred.
那么尽管呢, 法利赛人呢, 还有宗教领袖, 他们听了耶稣宣称自己是弥赛亚, 他们的回应就是拒绝还有憎恨。
And so in response to this situation, Jesus said in Matthew 7, 6, saying, do not give dogs what is sacred, do not throw your pearls to pigs. If you do, they may trample them under their feet and turn and tear you to pieces.
那为此呢, 耶稣呢, 也在马太福音 7章6节这里就回应到呢, 不要把圣物给狗, 也不要把你们丢在猪前, 恐怕他践踏了珍珠, 转过来咬你们。
In short, don't waste time or invite harassment from those who are obviously hostile. It's simply a waste of God-given resources.
总而言之呢, 就不要浪费时间还有精力呢, 去和那些明显一些敌对的那些人的, 你跟他争辩, 因为这简直就是浪费上帝赐予你, 赐予的这种资源啊。
With all this going on, I can conclude this.
这一切呢, 我可以这样, 我可以这样总结呢,
Relationships are difficult.
关系是很复杂的。
Period. Relationships are difficult.
关系呢是蛮复杂的。
All of us, Christians or not, all of us are sinners. And when sinners and sinners interact with each other, sinning against God and one another are bound to happen.
那我们世人呢, 都犯过罪了嘛, 我们罪人跟罪人之间呢, 就难免会, 会冒犯上帝, 以及冒犯我们彼此的。
This is why Jesus reminds us to pray.
这就是为什么耶稣他提醒我们要祷告。
So after talking about relationship with one another, Jesus moves on to talk about our relationship with our Heavenly Father.
那当, 刚才之前所讨论完的这一些彼此之间的关系的时候呢，耶稣接下来呢就讨论到我们与天父的关系。
Matthew 7:7 says, Ask and it will be given to you, Seek and you will find, Knock and the door will be opened to you.
马太福音7:7这里说到呢，你们祈求就给你们，寻找就寻见，叩门就给你们开门。
Now ask, seek, knock, there are two ways we can look at this.
这里呢，寻求、寻见以及叩门，我们有这两个方式能够来看。
One, we see a rising intensity.
第一个呢，就是我们逐渐这个加深这个迫切感。
From asking for it to seeking or looking for it and then knocking for it.
从请求啊到寻找到叩门呢，我就体现了这个迫切感的这种逐渐加深的这个阶段。
Number two, it is a perpetual action.
第二个呢，就是持续不断的这个行动。
This one is seen in the Greek grammatical tense.
那这个呢，从希腊文的这些的语态的这个时态的方式里面，我们可以看到。
So a more accurate way to express in the English is keep on asking, keep on seeking, keep on knocking.
那用英文的简单的了解的就是所谓的我持续的祈求，持续的寻找，持续的叩门。
So the persistent and constant prayer is the emphasis here.
所以这边呢强调的是坚持不断的要去祷告。
However, I want to suggest to us, while knowing how, okay, how we ought to ask God for good things is important.
那我想建议大家呢，虽然知道如何向神祈求这个美好的事情是个很重要的。
There is a greater promise here for us that has to do with our relationship with God.
这里呢，含着我们对跟上帝的关系一个很重大的一个应许。
Now I want you to do an exercise with me. Imagine you are standing in front of a door.
那我要求各位呢，就来跟我操练一下，就你想象一下，现在你站在一个门前。
So you have a request that you need to bring to the person behind this door, or you just have something you want to tell the person.
那现在你有一个要求，或者是你有一个你想对这个门的另外一边的这个人呢来去说，或者是一个要求。
So I want you to imagine knocking the door by knocking on the chair in front of you lah. You find a way lah,
huh? 大家想象一下，你现在你叩门呢，就叩现在你座位前面的那个座位的那个靠背的那个椅子的背。
Yeah.
你想象一下，你叩门。
Yep. So now let me ask you, how would you knock the door if the person behind the door is your boss? If for student, your principal, how would you knock it?
那如果你想象一下，你这个坐在你前面的这个椅子的这个人呢，可能是你的老板。如果你是学生的话，可能就是校长。Okay. 你想象一下，你会怎么去扣这个门
？Okay, on the count of three, you try and knock for me. Okay.
数到三的时候，你试想想，你会怎样扣这个门
？1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
Quite. Okay. Now, how would you knock the door if it's your best friend? Wait. If it's your best friend, 你翻译一下。
好啊。各位不用激动哦，你想一想一下，如果前面这个人呢是你的好朋友，你会怎样叩门呢
？Okay, on the count of three, your best friend 啊 1, 2, go.
二三，好朋友，你会怎样敲门
？Hey, I didn't know shouting can knock door, you know.
我们预料到原来喊也是一个方。
Some of you didn't knock. I know you don't knock the door straight away, open the door.
有一些人是没有敲门的，我知道你可能就直接打开门了，是不是
？Okay, the third one. How would you knock the door if it's someone?You don't know or meeting for the first time.
第三个呢，就是你会怎样敲门？如果你根本不知道门对面的那个是谁，你根本不知道是谁，你会怎样的去敲门
？Okay, 1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
Even more gentle than the boss and the principal.
我这个呢，就比你之前那个你的校长、你的老板呢，来的更加的更加的轻。
In our experience, okay, in our experience,
在我们的经验呢
，there are at least three types of knock.When people come to the flat to look for us,
通常呢，有三种的敲门呢。当有人去到这个我们的住宿来找我们的。
The first one is something like this.
第一种，就这样。
Knock three times softly.
就三次。
So we roughly know, or should be don't know which member want to find us or send something for us.
就很轻轻的敲三次，我们就大概可以预料到，哦，可能是有弟兄姐妹，可能是要有东西要给我们的，或者是其他弟兄姐妹。
Then a second knock, now seldom lah this one, but last time used to have this.
那第二种呢，就是现在比较少了，要以前呢是很常发生的这样的敲门，就这样。
And we would roughly know, oh, who is it?
我们就大概知道这是谁了。
The third knock.
站总的敲门,
still happening nowadays.
到现在为止还在发生的。 就有机关枪似的。
And then we would, 哇,机关枪, very good. Then we would know, who is it?
那我们也知道, 哦,那是谁哦,知道是谁。
Now, when this person say want to come to look for us,
当这样子敲门的人要找我们呢,
but after a while, the knock is like this.
过不多久,那个敲门变成这个很轻巧的时候呢,
my wife and I will look at each other, who is it?
我太太两个就会互望,就会好奇地说,这是谁啊?
The person behind the door, our relationship with the person determines how we knock, how persistent we knock.
我们跟门 对面的另外一边的那个人的关系怎样呢？就决定我们敲门的方式以及力度。
I want to ask you, who is God to you?
我想问弟兄姐妹呢，谁的上帝对你来说是怎样的一位神呢？
Is he a vending machine that you expect to get something you want in return after you put in effort, money, and time?
它是不是就是一个很像的一个自动贩卖机这样子？当你放了钱之后呢，它就会给你一些时间啊，给你一些其他东西等等来回报你的。
Or is he an ATM that you draw something from only when there's a need?
或者就是一个提款机呢，当我有需要钱的时候呢，我就去提款。
Or is he your father and you are his beloved child?
或者呢，他是你的父神，也是你自己呢，也是他所爱的那孩子。
Our confidence in prayer is not rooted in our ability to pray, but in the manifestly loving nature of our Father in heaven.
我们祷告的这个信心呢，是并不在于我们祷告的这个的能力，而是呢，奠基于我们天父显而易见的那个慈爱的这个本质。
In Matthew 7:11, I call it the perfect 7:11. If you then, though you are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Father in heaven give good gifts to those who ask him?
那马太福音7:11呢，我就称它为最完美的7:11。那这里就说到呢，你们虽然不好啊，况且。 尚且知道拿好东西给儿女，何况你们在天上的父，岂不更把好东西给求他的人吗？
Human beings are by nature sinful, and even then they give their children what they need instead of what will harm them.
人性呢，本来呢就是充满这个罪恶的，但父母呢总会给孩子他们所需要的，而不是会伤害他们的东西。天父呢，同样。
Truly, God the Father does the same. And Jesus here, he promises a radical attentiveness from God the Father to the prayers of his children. So it is an invitation to interact with a generous Father who loves to hear the prayers of his children.
那就这个就好像是一个邀请，让我们与一位慷慨的天父一样的互动。那么这位天父呢，也喜爱聆听孩子们的祷告。And
not to treat God like a magic genie who we can control or who grants every wish that we ask.
我们并不是把神当作这个神灯的精灵呢，就是他能够实现我们任何的愿望。
Be children of the Heavenly Father, trusting Him to be the best giver of all things good.
成为天父的孩子，就是要信靠他，永远都是会把最好的一个东西给我们的这个施予者。
Now every time when we said this, probably another question pops to mind.
当我们每次讲这个事情的时候呢，就有另外一个问题产生了。
What if the best giver doesn't seem to be giving me an answer?
那么一个最好的这个施恩者呢，他能不给我答案的时候怎么办？对，当这个很乐意施恩慷慨的父，乐意施的，他不给我想要求的这个的内容时候呢，会怎么办呢？
Does it mean God the Father is no longer generous and loving?
这是不是表示说呢，我们的天父他不再慷慨，也不再爱我们呢？
Now those are the moments. And other times when we need to humble ourselves before God the Father and put our we need to humble ourselves before God the Father and confess that we have put our faith on something else.
这时候呢，其实呢，我们就应该来要谦卑的来到父的面前。那么要再次的审查自己，有否呢，我们把我们的这个的对神的信靠呢，放在别的地方上呢？
Like what Reverend Richard said last week, is it need to empty the bank, then only we know how to put our trust in God again?
那会不会很像就是邵军牧师在上个礼拜的信息分享说，是不是我们要把我们的这个银行账户清空呢，才知道我们是不是爱神的呢？
Faith in God is so important because faith is our soul's connection to God, the foundation of prayer, regardless of the outcome. It trusts that even God's no is in the spirit of yes, always given or withheld through Christ.
信靠上帝呢，是非常重要的。 因为信仰是我们与上帝的连接，是祷告的根基。无论结果如何呢，我们都相信他。即使上帝他对上帝他说不，其实也涵盖着是的这个心意。那么始终呢，我们透过基督给予，那么始终神呢都会透过基督来给予我们，或者是暂且不给予我们。How
I would understand it is like this.
那我如何了解呢？这段话呢？When
I say no ice cream to Ezekiel,
当我说 Ezekiel, 你不能够有雪糕，不能。
When I say no ice cream to him, I'm saying yes to his health.
当我对他说 你不可以有雪糕的时候呢，其实我是对他说，我是对你的健康说是重视的意思。
When I'm stressed out, I want to drink coke, and I tell myself no, no coke today.
那当我感到很压力的时候呢，我要喝可乐的时候呢，我就说不可以，因为今天不可以喝可乐。
And it is saying no to coke and saying yes to less weight.
那当我对这个可乐说不的时候呢，那我就对我的这个健康的说是。
God the Father may seem to be saying no or saying nothing at all.
我们的父神呢，可能对我们说不，或者是保持沉默。
But a question and challenge for us, but would you continue to first and foremost seek Him and not the answer?
那么这种我们要寻求的最终的这个的答案的目的呢，就是呢，我们还会当上帝，当我们的父神对我们说不或者沉默的时候呢，我们还会持续寻求他，而是去寻求他吗？而不是只是很执着的去求那个答案。
In short, we need to pray to seek God the Father, not the answer.
简单来说呢，我们是祷告寻求我们的天父，而不是寻求我们祷告的答案。
It changes the whole relationship with God.
这个却改变我们与父神，完全改变我们与父神的关系。
And church, tonight as we sing this song as a response,
弟兄姐妹，当我们今晚唱这首回应诗的时候呢，
we want to come back to God as our Father.
我们要来到上帝面前，称他为我们的父。
It is only when our relationship with Him is right,
唯独我们跟他的关系在正确的时候呢，
when we love God wholeheartedly,
当我们全心全意爱主的时候，
then only then we can love people warmheartedly.
那我们才能呢，能够带着爱以及热忱的去爱别人。
Would you stand together with me and sing this song as a response? 那么一同站立，我们一同来以这首诗歌来回应我们上帝。